But let's break this tweet that has just come in from the Twitter handle of Dr. S. Jayashankar. He in fact goes on to say, spoke just now to the Israeli finance minister about the explosion outside the embassy. We take this very seriously. He goes on to say, assured him of the fullest protection for the embassy and the Israeli diplomats. Matter is under investigation and no effort will be spared to find the culprits. So amongst the highest echelons in the government, you're looking at everyone right now closely monitoring the entire situation. This is where I want to get in a word from our learned guests here before I go back to ground zero with Shravan and Atul. To you first, Suresh Kumar Goel, sir. You're a former diplomat, sir. How do you read what has happened so far? Do you think that there are eerie similarities between what happened in 2012 and what happened this evening?
Infructuous to draw comparisons between what happened earlier and what is happening today. There are separate incidents. Israeli embassy is a very, very sensitive area in terms of security. We all know the reasons for this thing. And the fact is that the whole area is so sensitive, VVIP area, as I said before, that the security here in this area is normally very, very good. And therefore, to have this kind of an incident is a bit, is rather a surprising thing, that there was no intelligence input on such a possible development taking place, and that police security was not really informed or they had no information on this thing. At the moment, I would only simply say that we have to leave it to the security people. Let them investigate, let them find out who are responsible. This is not going to impact, as the EAM has also made it very clear, it is not going to impact on our relations. It has no bearing on the good relations that we have between India and Israel. It has no diplomatic implications, no foreign policy implications. It is simply and straightforward a security matter, and that should be treated in that manner. Expeditious investigation into what happened, catch the culprits who did this thing, and punish them. That's the only way, and let the Israelis know, let everybody know that we are very, very serious about security in this area. Thank you.
All right, Major General Gaurav Arya is also joining us on the broadcast, but I want to get in now a word with Major General Rajan Kochar. Major General Saab, we heard earlier a statement that has come in through sources in the Delhi police that goes on to say that this is a mischievous attempt to create a sensation. What is your first reading, sir, or what has happened today?
You see, my first reading is that these militants who would have breached into the capital were waiting for an opportunity. 26th January, the security is very tight, so that opportunity did not come their way. They would have reconnaissance the entire area, and they would have also watched the movement of the security forces in this area and the state of alertness. And that is why the time which has been chosen in the evening, it's also that beating the retreat is also taking place, so the resources of the Delhi police are extremely stretched. So they have taken the opportunity. Second is that what I can presume is it is a explosive which would be either TNT or RDX, because that kind of impact which can be heard and the kind of explosion which has been there, it has to relate to either a TNT based IED or a RDX based IED. Thirdly is that because it is a high security area, it may not have been possible for them to carry out larger explosives. So it was done in a manner that
yes,
they could hide this kind of a thing and bring it here, because the international impact of either a low blast or a high blast would remain the same, because it would actually sensationalize the entire thing in the world media, and that yes. kind of attention, and especially it happens in front of an Israeli embassy, and Pakistan has no foreign ties with Israel, and it is well known to them that so we enjoy a special relationship with Israel, and especially a defense pact is there with them. We are getting a lot of weapons and equipments from Israel. So it is all an overall design, I feel, which has been done to sensationalize the issue as well as to send us a message to Delhi that we can strike in the heart of the capital. Mm.
You know, I think that that's quite a comprehensive look at what's happened this evening, Major General Ranjan Kocharsa. And I also want to say good evening to Ashok Sajjanhar, who's a former diplomat who's just joined us on the broadcast. And before I come to you and Gaurav Arya and Major General K.K. Sinha Saab, there is one more quick breaking update. And do remember again, because this is a live fluid situation on our screens, we will be continuously looking at those images. We'll also cut across to our reporters as and when they have an update. Now, this is the Israeli Foreign Ministry that has said that all its diplomats and the embassy staff are safe and sound following a blast outside the embassy in New Delhi. But then, what really was the target? Was this a major security breach? Because do remember the area, ladies and gentlemen, those of you who are not very familiar with Delhi, this is just under 2 kilometers from the venue where the beating retreat ceremony was happening at the Vijaypath area. And what you see on your screens are just images of moment before this entire blast was reported at 5:05 this evening. On the right now is the impact. No one has been injured, but this is an image telling you of the impact on about 4 to 5 cars that were parked very close to the pavement. I'm just going to return back to all our guests and reporters on the other side of this quick break, and our non-stop rolling coverage continues. Do not go anywhere.